Hi children, so a new day, a new class, so a new topic altogether with the same chapter, voice, active and passive. So we have come to the end, fag end of this chapter, and here we are left with one part, that is the interrogative sentences. Now what is an interrogative sentence? A sentence which basically ends with a question mark at the end are known as to be the interrogative sentences. So today we are going to learn or talk about the interrogative sentences. When we have to change it from active to passive, what are the changes that we have to make while doing so? So change in voice of interrogative sentences. As I told you, the word interrogative basically talks about a question mark. So there are two types of there are two different ways of asking question. One is which, that starts with WH. What is your name? Where do you live? Where are you going? So it starts with WH. And the other one is the other one is this, that it starts with helping verb. If you remember, it starts with helping verb like did, okay, do. So these are some of the words, these are the two types in which you can frame a question, right? So let us see. Number one, the helping verb has, have, had, will, shall, can, and may. Now these are all the helping verbs or types of helping verbs that we have learnt in English grammar so far. So it says that do not change their position. They don't change their position. In active, if it is in the beginning of the sentence, it will remain in the beginning of the sentence. In passive also, in passive voice also. Let us see the example. Will you read the rules is in active voice, right? So when we change it into passive voice, it will be like this. Will the rules be read by you? So we have learned you remains you. So over here also you is remaining as you. The common thing that we have learned, that we have to use by. So by also remains like that. And you see, will has not changed its place. Only the verb has changed its form little bit as per the tenses that we have learned previously in page number 115. As per that, there are some changes. Apart from that, there is no basic change in the position of the helping verbs. So whether it is has done, has, have, had, will, shall, can, may, whatever it is there, it will not change its place. Next, point number two. Point number two says that the question words who, whom, what, when, where, and how do not change their position. Like the helping verb, the question words also do not change their position. It remains in the same place, like we have just now seen an example. But who changes to whom when we change from active to passive, or whom changes to who when we change it from active to passive? This is one thing that you have to keep it in mind. Otherwise, the place or the placement of the helping verb and the WH words or HOW how remains the same when we talk about changing of interrogative sentence, which is in active voice, to be changed into passive voice, right? So let us see the example. Who gave you this idea? So whom was this idea given to you by? So actually the question is, who gave you this idea? When we change it into passive voice, it becomes whom was this idea given to you by. So this is very simple, and by now, after doing so many exercises in this chapter, I think you are pro and you will be able to do this exercise, that is exercise number E, in your grammar copy very easily. But still I have put up three sentences for us to understand it in a better way. May I attend the meeting? So the question, the interrogative question is like this, and we have to, this is in active voice and we have to change it into passive voice. So as it is said that helping verb will not change its place. So first thing first, you write the helping verb. May the meeting May the meeting be attended by me. This is how it changes. Right? If you remember, I changes to me. In last class I told you, okay, so that you see I has changed to me. Moment it is after the verb, it changes into me. Whom did you see crying? Whom did you see crying? The next question. So here we have just now learned that whom, if it is there whom, then we have to change it into who, and if there is who, it has to be changed into whom. So over here, whom is there? You will have to write who was crying. First thing first, who was crying seen by you? Okay, so who was crying seen by you? Next, where have you kept the keys? So here, first of all, the position will not change and the word will also not change because it does not fall under the category of who or whom. So we will write where first. So where, where, what it has said, where have you kept the keys? Where have, or you can also write are, okay, where have or are the keys been kept by you? Where are the keys, or where have the keys been kept by you? So keeping all these things in mind, please get down to do exercise number E in your grammar copy and send it to me for correction, please, by 7 p.m. today. That's it for the day today. Thank you. Bye-bye, and take good care of yourself.